Well, welcome to Riverbank Arena in Olympic Park in London for a Pool B women's hockey match between New Zealand and Germany at the London 2012 Olympic Games. This match is going to be vital for both sides, particularly New Zealand, as they try and make the semi-finals at an Olympic Games for the first time. New Zealand need to win this match to guarantee their place in the top four. For Germany, it's going to be much harder for them to qualify. They need to win by at least 3 goals in this match and then hope results in the other pool matches go their way. Temperatures, conditions are pretty good for this match in the Riverbank Arena. 16 degrees with quite a high humidity rate, so there could be the chance of a shower or two. So here are the standings in Pool B at the moment. So if New Zealand win, they will secure 3 more points on the competition pool standings and move to 12 points. That will guarantee themselves a place in the semi-finals with Australia and Argentina due to play each other later. United States versus South Africa also coming up in Pool B. The crowd is streaming in. Crowd has been supporting the hockey games in great numbers. You might have seen the flags flying in that last shot. Just a gentle breeze wafting over Riverbank Arena. So New Zealand go into this match having won 3 of their 4 matches. And Germany have not been as impressive, but they are still in with a chance. They have won 2 of their 4 matches. And most importantly, they have a very good record against New Zealand in past international matches. But New Zealand are the form team at the moment. So big support for New Zealand as they try and qualify for the semi-finals. They'll be playing in the white, and Germany in the dark strip. Yes, New Zealand's international record against Germany, it's in head-to-head matches. Germany, most comprehensive. They have played 12 times in international matches, and Germany have won 8 of them. New Zealand only 1, and the other 3 have been drawn. New Zealand's only win against Germany in a major international competition was at the 1990 World Cup. So 22 years it's been since New Zealand beat Germany in an international women's hockey match. And there's the captain, Kayla Sharland. So Fanny Rinner, the captain of Germany, very experienced player. So there is the German team, very experienced side. 10 of the squad have played more than 100 matches for their country, with 4 of them playing more than 200. It's time now for the national anthems before the start of this match. So much at stake for both sides as we get ready for this women's Pool B preliminary match between New Zealand and Germany. New Zealand hoping to beat Germany for the first time in 22 years, and there is their starting 11, held together, of course, by Kayla Sharlin, number one. She's the captain of this New Zealand side, 173 matches, and she scored 3 goals in this tournament. And the substitutes, plenty of pace and experience in that New Zealand substitutes bench. The German side, headed by their captain, number 16, Fanny Rinner. She's played a number of games for her country, 339. She's not the most experienced player, though. That honour goes to Natasha Keller, number 7, 423 games for Germany. And plenty of experience on the bench, too, particularly with Jennifer Pluss, having scored 19 goals, played 111 matches. The umpires for this match from Argentina, Soledad Iparaguay. And the second umpire for the match is Australian Lisa Roach. Mark Hager is the New Zealand coach. It's been so for a little while now. He is actually on a former Australian men's player, Mark Hager. So we're almost ready for a start. And the German coach, Michael Beermann. So underway in this Pool B women's hockey match between New Zealand in the white and Germany in the dark strip. New Zealand's trying to beat Germany for the first time in 22 years, and in doing so they will guarantee themselves a place in the semi-finals at this competition, and that will be the highest ever achievement for New Zealand at an Olympic Games. And Anita Punt into the goal circle, straight away, a chance for New Zealand. Wow, that was very close in the opening 30 seconds. Harrison, Anita Punt, the pace of Anita Punt into the shooting circle. So close for Harrison. Charlotte Harrison. Open goal pretty much. New Zealand still attacking. Germany's world ranking is 3. And they haven't really performed up to that ranking so far. They still have a chance to make them semi-finals themselves, though, but they need a big win to just get themselves into contention. They need to win by at least 3 goals. And here's some good stick work by New Zealand. That was Mikkelsen. But now Germany take it away. Sturkel, though, hands back possession to New Zealand. Punt again. Electric pace. And it looks like one of the German players, in fact, it's Fanny Rinner who's been hit in the hand. That will be a nasty collision there with the ball. Oh, yes, yeah, she copped it. It was Forgeson with the shot. Rinner looks in a bit of discomfort. Looked like a nasty hit on the hand, no question about it. New Zealand goalkeeper is Bianca Russell. Oh, there's been the turnover in possession here. Into the shooting circle. And it's out for a long corner. New Zealand will not underrate Germany. They are a very, very experienced and successful side over the years. Free hit to New Zealand. And here's space. Finlayson looks to get the ball back. Forgeson. Now Germany come away. Sturkel. Off the foot, so Germany come away with it. It's out for a corner. Germany decide to build things from the back. Haas. So how's Fanny Rinner on the bench there? See when she comes back on. Hasselman. That's a good pass. Charlton cuts it out though. And now New Zealand. Finlayson. Naylor. Pass is cut out. And Germany. A couple of loose passes as Charlin looks to play it forward. Punt couldn't trap the ball though. 5 minutes gone in this Pool B match and it's nil all. Oh, it's been left open. Here's a chance for Germany. Just lacked the support in the shooting circle. Did Wilder. New Zealand will be a little disturbed that one of those players let that ball through. A little fortunate to get away with it. It's good control by Flynn. Good pace from Gemma Flynn. Scored a goal earlier in the tournament. Playing her 117th match for New Zealand. Katie Glynn in there, conceding the free hit. This is Haas. Stöckel. Very good in midfield for Germany. It's nicely cut out. That will be a free hit to New Zealand if hit the ball, hit the foot of Plas. So Fanny Rinnett is going to come back on now, and she seems perfectly fine. That was a nasty hit on the hand she received earlier. New Zealand have managed to secure a very high number of penalty corners in the tournament so far, more than any other team in the competition. Conversion rate, though, 24%. So they're getting themselves plenty of opportunities. Perhaps not converting as many as they would like. Having said that, they've still won three of their four matches. Germany have converted 33% of their penalty corners, but they've only managed to have 12 opportunities in that facet, so a little bit light in that area. It's been a fairly even start to the match. A big opportunity early, remember, for Harrison in the opening 30 seconds. Headed into the side netting. That could be cut out, and this could be useful for New Zealand. Flynn. It's a nice pass from Hahn. Here's Keller. Trying to get a free hit out of the umpire. Didn't come, though. No whistle. Here come Germany again. Issues. Oh, that's excellent play from her. The former Dutch junior player. Hunt just losing control of it that time. Out for a 16-yard hit. New Zealand have possession. 10 minutes gone in this Paul B match, and it's New Zealand 0, Germany 0. So New Zealand come in the midfield now. Oh, there's a player open! And it's play on, no whistle. New Zealand surely! New Zealand, their second good chance for them. Excellent play. What vision there. Beautiful pass. And it was Katie Glynn who just couldn't quite get that trap accurate enough. And even now, we saw that second opportunity. But it was all hands on deck for Germany there. They really scrambled out of that one very well indeed. Charlotte Harrison who came in and tried to have a shot and it was blocked. So Germany got back very effectively. And now Germany, well, not, they're just final passes, just not sticking at the moment. Germany still in possession, into the shooting circle. Wow, that's been Germany's first big opportunity. Bianca Russell will be sighing, big sigh of relief. That attempt not quite attempted. So a 16-yard hit for New Zealand. Three New Zealanders putting pressure on, and Germany come away. Rinner. And the umpire wanting the ball move back. That's Lisa Roach from Australia. Cooper. That's excellent short passing from New Zealand. Oh, Glynn's trip there. That should be a penalty corner. So the first penalty corner has taken 13 minutes. And a clear trip there from Mandy Haas. So New Zealand's had 25 penalty corner chances in the tournament. And here's the first one of this match. They've scored six goals from 25 attempts so far. So conversion rate of 24%. So the pressure on Germany here. Watch for Kayla Sharland and also Clarissa Eschus to be involved here. It's going to be Eschus who's lining up there. Just wide. 22 minutes to play in this first half. Not far away, but the German goalkeeper did well to get up there. Yvonne Frank. Germany did very well there. Now there's a chance for them in the circle. It's been an exciting match so far. That's nice play from New Zealand. A little bit strong that pass. Harrison had no chance to get that one. Two sisters in this New Zealand team, Samantha Harrison and Charlotte Harrison. Charland. Cut out beautifully. Now Germany have the chance. Hasselmann. Coughed up. Away comes Harrison. It's Samantha Harrison. Lots of German players back though on defence that time. Sharland. Remember, one of the rules of hockey is that a goal, if it goes into the goal from outside the shooting circle, it will not count. Those goals can only be scored once you move into that shooting circle. And that is a 16-yard hit to Germany. Minutes to play in this first half. It's New Zealand 0, Germany 0, and New Zealand take it quickly. Glynn into the shooting circle, but look at all those German players back. A lot of players back on defense there. Mikkelsen is dispossessed. Issues. Is Keller, the most experienced of the German players, 423 matches. Now New Zealand in space, and here's punt. Oh, it's still alive. And again, New Zealand threatening on attack. New Zealand really asking plenty of this German defence in this match so far. Still no goals though. That's a good pass. Now Germany move forward. It's good play. But issues got back for New Zealand. Hahn just couldn't quite get that pass into a teammate. Another corner. Bianca Russell. Now Germany try a different tactic. They're going to build from the back. Here's Scharland. Oh, she's lost possession. Here come Germany. Always a chance. Reverse stick shots. Hahn was the player. One of the younger players in this German side, just 22 years of age. Germany is spending more time in New Zealand's half now. Space on the left. And it's come off a German foot, so Wilder. A little unlucky there. All right, New Zealand go on the left again. But here's space. It's a nice pass. Cooper. Coming forward. Is that Finlayson? It's Finlayson. There's a good pass. Punt. Wow, that was a big trap needed there from Charlotte Harrison. The opportunity goes begging there for New Zealand. One of the players has copped it in the back of the head there. Seems maybe the shoulder. Can't do that. There's Naylor the player. That's excellent work. Hahn it is. That's a beautiful ball too. Muller Wieland on the right-hand side. Germany will have another chance. So Germany have a free hit here. Fanny Rinner, their captain. We'll ask something of the New Zealand defence here, it seems. But New Zealand have the ball. Awarding the free hit was Lisa Roach, the umpire from Australia. So Naylor hit on the shoulder, just below the shoulder. She should be okay. This is Keller. Germany in possession. Jennifer Plass to take the corner. That's a good pass. Penalty corner is awarded. That's Germany's first of the game. Now, there is a video referral system in hockey. New Zealand are allowed to have an official on the sideline review it if they so choose, but they've chosen not to refer that. So nervous times on the bench for Mark Hager. Germany's conversion rate from the penalty corner spot has been 33% this tournament so far. So Hustleman, the player to take the penalty corner. And it's fractionally wide, not far away for the Germans. 12 minutes to play in this first half. And it's nil all. New Zealand in the white strip, remember, Germany in the dark strip. And it's been a very willing and even match so far. New Zealand perhaps with the more scoring opportunities. But Germany have certainly not been out of it. Remember, New Zealand have not beaten Germany in a women's hockey match for 22 years. So history certainly on the side of Germany. But New Zealand in better form at the moment, having won three of their four matches at this tournament. That was a good piece of work from Harrison. Good long pass, Sterkel. Waiting and holding for the ball for her teammates. Kala plays it in. New Zealand needed their goalkeeper off the line there. Bianca Russell did well. Plus. Charlin trying to dispossess the ball. And so New Zealand have one possession. takes it quickly. New Zealand threatening here, a bit of space. Oh, that last pass needed to be made, and there would have been a big chance for Samantha Harrison. Well, a poor pass that time. Issues. Handing away possession fairly easily there to Germany. Haas trying to build something up for Germany from the back. Is there enough support up for New Zealand? Forgerson. All space for Germany. Stoeckel just couldn't find her teammate. That pass needed to be made, perhaps a fraction earlier. Here goes punt. This is Gunson. Charlton, issues, whoops. Germany take it quickly. Players moving forward now. Well, here we go. Stay saved by Russell. Great save, Bianca Russell, for New Zealand. How vital will that be? That's the best save and best chance of the match. And now New Zealand break. Has she got enough support? It's wide. Well, a thrilling piece of play by both sides in that last 30 seconds. Big chance for Germany. This, the best chance of the match so far. Russell closing those legs just in time. On another day, that might have sneaked through and been a goal. Not to be today. Now Germany move forward again. Hillman. This is Müller Wieland. Germany just looking a bit more threatening now. And New Zealand being forced to scramble a bit more than they perhaps like. Skürzer. And away come New Zealand on the break, and they just couldn't get that stick. It was always going to be a tough trap, that one. That's nice play. Müller. Good stick work there. Oh, hook back. It's going to be a penalty corner, though. It's off the foot one of the New Zealanders. Ball touches the foot in the circle, of course. It's a penalty corner. So, New Zealand forced to defend again. So, Germany much coming into the match much more now. Those last 5 minutes, they've look very strong. So pressure for the New Zealand defence again. Second penalty corner of the match. Saved by Russell again. She's having a superb match. Two brilliant stops now. This is Melody Cooper. Finlayson. New Zealand not really got enough support up there. And that was easily cut out in the end. So here's that penalty corner again. Watch the stop from Russell. So Germany will have another chance inside the last 3 minutes of the first half here. They've really come into this match, creating several chances, a couple of very good chances, threatening from those penalty corners too. New Zealand have to retreat. Remember, Germany, the world number 3, New Zealand world number 6. And New Zealand have only ever had one win over Germany in international women's hockey before. Was that a deflection in? Well, we're going to have a video referral here. Germany very confident they got the deflection in. They needed to get a touch on it inside the goal circle, remember? Oh, that's hard to tell, isn't it? Did it take a deflection? The Germans are certainly claiming it. Did it touch the stick? Well, there's a big, big decision coming up for the official here. The video umpire. Did Vilda get a touch on it? This is a big, big decision in the context of this match and the tournament. Let's have a look again. Boy, it's hard to tell. It may have just clipped her hand. Did it clip the stick? Everyone on the edge of their seats here. Did it touch the stick? Gee, it's hard to tell. Her hand was down. You can see the glove on her hand. Oh, it's hard to tell. Did it just touch that glove? Did it touch the stick? Everyone's waiting. Yeah, they've got one up there. This is taking a long, long time, isn't it? Everyone waiting. The Germans certainly claimed it immediately.
Okay, thank you.
Solly, and you saw nothing there either, Solly?
Yep, sorry. Yep, okay.
No goal. Well, the Germans aren't happy. But on the video evidence, you'd have to say there was no clear evidence to suggest that the stick had touched the ball. But sometimes replays don't pick up everything, so tough to call. Hard one for the video umpire either way, really. But there's nothing the players can do about it now, so Germany will have to put that to bed and carry on playing. Very important they do so. Inside the last 2 minutes of the first half. Katie Glynn in there, trying to be a nuisance. Rinner. Going to be New Zealand ball. Germany have been having a lot of possession in the last 10 minutes or so. It's been an entertaining first half. 8 shots on goal for Germany, 6 for New Zealand. And both teams have had 2 very good chances. Of course, Germany a moment ago having that goal ruled out. Plus. Yeah, Keller just a little aggressive there. And New Zealand just getting it down field and hoping in these last 20 seconds to just soak it up, reassess at halftime. Certainly started the better of the two sides, but Germany have ended the stronger, no question. One more chance for Germany, perhaps. Half time in this Pool B women's preliminary match at the London 2012 Olympic Games. Been a very entertaining half between New Zealand and Germany, but no goals. It's nil all. Bianca Russell has certainly been a favourite for New Zealand. She put in 2 fantastic stops in that first half. Keller, though, the experienced German, led her team back into that first half very well. Germany certainly ending that one in good form. Really did dominate possession and field territory in that last 15 minutes or so. And that goal, which the Germans claimed a couple of minutes out from half-time, which was ruled out by the video referee, or the video umpire, rather, that will be a crucial decision. So it's nil all at half-time between Germany and New Zealand. So here are the first half highlights. And this happened very early on inside the first 2 minutes. And Harrison for New Zealand, Charlotte Harrison, open goal there, just couldn't quite get into position to convert the opportunity. New Zealand had good chances early on in the match. This pass was an absolute beauty to Glynn. Credit to the German defence there. They really scrambled, put their bodies on the line, several players, including the keeper, Yvonne Frank, did very well. Really committed herself to stopping Katie Glynn there. So that was wonderful goalkeeping from Yvonne Frank in her 23rd match. New Zealand's had just the one penalty corner chance, and that's how close they were. Just a fraction wide. Germany came back into the match though. Hahn was disappointed. She didn't do better with that reverse stick shot. But the German midfield started to get into the match a bit more with Skürzer, Rinner taking control of the midfield, and they managed to get two penalty corner opportunities themselves. That was the first one. And this one here, check out the stop from Russell. Closing the legs at just the right time for New Zealand. Big, big chance for Germany. Two players up there and two very good stops in the same play. And then that there, tremendous stop again from another penalty corner to Germany. By now, Germany were dominating the match. Fanny Rinner, who got a whack on the hand early on in the match, marshalling and leading her team pretty well. So here are some statistics for you. You can see six chances to Germany, five chances to New Zealand. But despite no goals being scored, it's been a very entertaining match. The key moment, though, remember, just before halftime, inside that last 3 minutes, when there was a shot from outside the circle in the hope of a deflection coming off a German stick into the goal. The Germans claimed it, but after about a three-minute break and play where the video umpire looked and looked and looked again, the goal was not given. Germany were upset because they claimed it immediately, but video umpire ruled there was no touch, no deflection, or no evidence of a deflection on the three or four angles that we saw replayed. So the match stayed at nil all at half time. Conditions you can see are pretty good for this match, around 16 degrees, just a gentle breeze. It's quite humid, humidity up around the high 80s. So New Zealand will be hoping to get back into this match. They've seen the Germans really up it in the last 15 minutes of that first half, and New Zealand will be hoping to get some dominance again. And there's plenty of New Zealand support in the crowd for this match. Big opportunity for New Zealand, remember, to make the semi-finals. They've never made the semi-finals at the women's hockey tournament before at the Olympic Games. If they win this match, they will guarantee themselves a chance. Well, they will guarantee themselves a spot in the semi-finals. Germany must win by at least 3 goals to have a chance of making the semi-finals. This is the last pool match for both sides. Wonderful crowd in for this hockey match. Of all shapes and sizes and ages, a real family atmosphere. And of course, supporters anxious their team will win the match. Riverbank Arena playing host to the hockey tournament at the London 2012 Olympic Games. Half time between New Zealand and Germany in this women's pool B match. Nil all. Germany needing to win this match by at least 3 goals, and they have an excellent record over New Zealand through history. Played 12 times at international level. Germany have won 8 of those 12 matches. New Zealand only 1. Their only victory coming at the 1990 World Cup. 22 years since New Zealand beat Germany in women's hockey. So big stakes for New Zealand. If they can pinch a win in this game, Germany on form, a little bit down in this Olympic tournament, but in the world rankings, they're third. New Zealand is sixth, so history and rankings on the side of Germany in this game. Form perhaps on the side of New Zealand. New Zealand and Germany met at the Beijing 2008 Olympics. Germany winning 2-1 there on that occasion. So New Zealand have some history to rectify from their point of view. Almost set for a start in the second half now. Is he into the game? His parents are trying hard. Yeah, wonderful family atmosphere at the Riverbank Arena. Second half underway between Germany in the dark strip and New Zealand in the white strip. This is a women's Pool B preliminary match, the London 2012 Olympic Games, and it's nil all, 35 minutes to play. Remember, for New Zealand, a win will see them into the semi-finals. Germany need a big win to give themselves a chance of making the semi-finals. And Germany ending the first half stronger of the two sides. Müller plays it forward. And that will be a corner. Stürkel. Infringement against Germany. So Clarissa Eschus scored 2 goals at the tournament so far for New Zealand. Well, that after that exchange, Germany have been given the free hit. First attacking chance of the second half. Close call, it's a penalty corner to Germany. The umpire, Lisa Roach from Australia, ruling that the ball touched the leg of a New Zealander. So So an early chance in the second half, and Germany start the second half the way they ended the first half. Bianca Russell, the New Zealand goalkeeper, being asked to perform again here perhaps. Hasselman, ready to take it. Another penalty corner given, I think. Yes. Yes, off the foot of Naylor. So the strategy sorted out by Hasselman and her teammates. What will we see this time from Germany? Another big opportunity. Here we go. And this time it's Russell again. German attempt at penalty corner, not so effective that time. Pretty easily cut out that one. Oh, here come Germany again. Can New Zealand clear? Can Germany get a shot away? No. In fact, they've conceded the ball, conceded possession. So Germany were a bit disappointed with the execution of that shot from Rinner. Just slightly deflected. And she'll be a bit upset that she didn't get more of a stick on that one. New Zealand trying to get some urgency, or Gemma Flynn trying to get urgency into the New Zealand attack. Away come Germany, sweeping forward again. Mula Wieland. Mikkelsen out there for New Zealand. And the younger players in this New Zealand side, 21 years of age, already played 106 games though. For her country. Oh, that's nice play. Shot comes in. Oh, it's over the top. Wow, Vilda it was. Off the New Zealand stick. What an opportunity for Germany. How fortunate for New Zealand. Just coming off the top of the stick. So the chances keep coming for the German side. New Zealand hanging on. Skürzer. Good stick work from her. It's a Schürzer again. Rinner. And couldn't control that one, the German captain. Kayla Sharland will be hoping her team, the New Zealand captain, hoping that they can find a bit more attacking opportunities. Certainly dried up. It's not going to help from Melody Cooper. Forgeson trying hard for her country. So Sharland plays it back to Forgeson. Oh, there was a deflection there. Good save by Frank, the German keeper. These keepers certainly having a good match. And we're going to have a referral. I think New Zealand are...
Team referral. Amy, are you there? Okay, can you just check for a foot off Germany just inside the circle?
So New Zealand arguing that the ball hit a German leg or foot. And if so, that will mean a penalty corner. Glynn did well to get in, stick in there, but excellent goalkeeping. Now this is where New Zealand are interested. And it seemed to just touch the right foot there of Keller. And Lisa Roach, the Australian umpire, missed it. She was just getting in position. As you can see, it was just one of those, her head was not looking and it has touched the foot there. Roach trying to get out of the way of it. Penalty corner is given, so New Zealand's referral is successful. Pretty easy one for Amy Hassock, the video umpire from the United States, to rule there. So New Zealand's second penalty corner of the game. Excellent stop by Frank. New Zealand set play pretty good that time if the shot lacked a little power. And Germany will win possession from the 16-yard line. So plenty of space, plenty of time for the shot to come in. Charlin's shot pretty effectively saved there by Yvonne Frank. So both goalkeepers having good matches. Here come Germany. Rinne still in possession for her team. It's a nice pass. Space. Another good stop. This time the shot came in from Hillman. Germany again into the goal circle. Pressure, big pressure again on the New Zealand defence here. Hoping for an deflection. Get it out of here, Bianca Russell. That's what she says. And it was played in a dangerous manner inside the circle. You have to be very quick as a keeper, and Bianca Russell kicking the ball away emphatically. Certainly keeping her team in it. Look at that. New Zealand have had 10 chances in the game now. Now has a chance. They want to take this quickly. But the Germans get back in defence. As you can see, the attempts on goal there. Germany have had 10 attempts on goal now. New Zealand just 5. And the majority of those attempts on goal came early on in the first half for New Zealand. Since then, it's been Germany in control of this match, but no goals. Charland. But two German players. Clash of the captains there, Fanny Rinne. Hahn unable to control that one. Mark Hager, the New Zealand coach. Nothing much he can do now. And Michael Beermann, the German coach, has got his team back into this match very, very effectively. Surely a goal to them is not far away. Looks like a penalty corner has been given to Germany. Ball off the foot again of one of the New Zealand players. So this is their fifth penalty corner of the match. Yep, off the leg there of Issues. Penalty corner to Germany. 23 and a half minutes to play in this Paul B match. New Zealand 0, Germany 0, and New Zealand have been hanging on in this match. Germany have been by far the stronger of the two sides up to this point. 10 shots on goal, no goals though. New Zealand only 5 shots on goal. So out scoring on the opportunities there by 2-1. Just wide again, but another penalty corner has been given. Gunson just getting a leg on it that time. Penalty corner number 6 to Germany. Oh, that was a poor pass. Is there a goal? No, I think it was ruled out. The whistle went before the goal went in, and we're going to have...
Didn't go travel outside the didn't
I
travel?
Took it twice outside the circle.
Yeah? On?
Yeah.
Okay. So you think it's a goal?
It's a goal.
Yeah? No, it's
outside, inside, outside, goal.
Okay, okay. You want to fill off?
Yeah.
Okay.
The
referral is here. It was umpire, was umpire.
No.
It was umpire referral. There was umpire referral. Okay? Everything clear? Okay?
I stopped it at the green out and then it was my back and side.
Okay, you take it out and then you take it in, but it still didn't travel out of the spot.
I take it
okay, enough. You ask for a referral, okay? Oh, wait, I'm going to ask. It's the chairman referral, okay, Amy? Can you hear me? Okay, I blow a high ball for the first shot to the goal. The ball didn't travel out of the 5 meter, and she said that she took twice the ball outside of the circle. So she went in, then she went out, and then she shot. Did you understand the question?
So quite a confusing situation here. I think we'll get to the bottom of it eventually.
Well, for me, it was too high to be the first shot to the goal. Of course, it's natural.
So this shot here.
The net, but she said that she took twice outside the circle, but that doesn't make any difference. The ball didn't travel outside of the five.
Well.
But can you check, please, if she's right? Okay. Listen.
Well, Amy Hasek, the US umpire chair, video umpire, has got another big decision to make here. The player is number 28, Julia Muller. Well, what's for certain is the ball ended up in the net. Let's have a listen.
Okay, it's a free hit for the defender. Okay?
The goal has been ruled out.
The Bayern referee said that it was a fair shot to the goal. It is right that you moved twice, but doesn't mean anything because the ball didn't travel outside the five, so the penalty corner didn't finish.
Okay,
is that
I
the
think
rule?
It's wrong, the rule.
Well, is the answer?
That's why we did the corner. Okay,
yes.
That's the
okay. To finish the penalty corner, you know, must travel out of the five, not out of the circle.
I don't know if it's true,
yeah.
But we have to.
Okay, that's it.
So
that's
there you go. You heard the
referral. Okay, Germany lose the referral.
So you heard the decision there, and Amy Hasek and the umpire from Argentina have done a good job there to sort out that referral, and that's the last time that Germany can refer, since that's been rejected now. So New Zealand still have their video referral left to use. They have one per match. If you succeed in your referral, you keep it, and they have actually successfully used their referral opportunity in the first half. In fact, it was early in the second half from memory. So they still have their referral, one referral left. So New Zealand hanging on. The ball has ended up in their goal twice. Both times been ruled out. Here come, this is a good little movement here from New Zealand. This is Flynn. Be interesting to see if the frustration starts to get to Germany. Been winning the match on the field, but on the scoreboard it still says nil all. Remember, Germany must win by a decent margin. At least three goals to have a chance of making the semi-finals. New Zealand could lose the match and still make the semi-finals. But if they win, they're guaranteed a place in the semi-finals. 20 minutes to play. Hasselman. And it was always going to be a very tough trap, that one, for Stürkel. Again, New Zealand dispossessed in midfield. Germany come forward again. Müller Wieland. Off the foot of Anita Punt. Plus. She gets the ball away. Oh, it's still alive. New Zealand escaped by the skin of their teeth again. In a courageous performance by the New Zealand goalkeeper, Bianca Russell. Put in some tremendous stops. Didn't know where the ball was for a second too, did she? Haas at the back for Germany. Müller Wieland. And a penalty corner given to Germany. Again off the foot of one of the New Zealand players. So the sixth penalty corner coming up for Germany. Surely it's just going to be a matter of time before Germany put one in the back of the goal. Already had a goal ruled out. Another one not given. Oh, that's tremendous scrambling from New Zealand. Schürzer gives it back to Vila Mulland. And some relief for the New Zealand side now. They'll have a chance to build from the back. But Germany quickly recapture possession. It's Otter. Well, Germany putting together a fairly solid performance here. They've lost two matches in this tournament. Rinner, the captain. And a free hit to Germany. Here's Keller. Germany continue to press. Dominating territory and possession. New Zealand skipper Kayla Sharland stops that one. This is Naylor. Mickelson trying to get something going for New Zealand. They've been really struggling to get it forward effectively for a long time in this match now. And they've lost the ball. Chance for Germany. Now Germany move forward. Schürzer plays it. But an infringement. Just over 15 minutes to play. It's New Zealand 0, Germany 0 in this women's Pool B preliminary match. Still plenty of time to play. Plenty of time to pinch a goal either side. Mickelson, Stacey Mickelson, 21-year-old. Finlayson, and New Zealand getting some territory here after a long period on defence. And that's out off a New Zealand stick. Mark Hager, the New Zealand coach, former Australian international. Done a great job with this New Zealand side at this tournament so far. This is a good run by Mulla Veland. tangle there. Time starting to tick away for Germany, though. They need a big win against New Zealand. At least three goals to make the semi-finals. So, three goals in 13 minutes is the ask. That's excellent play by Glynn. Play on. And here's Punt with all the pace. Gives it out to Harrison. That's good defense, though. Samantha Harrison just unable to control it for New Zealand. Big open territory here for Germany. But a crucial trap unable to be made by Mavis. And we've got a green card here. So one of the players is going to spend 2 minutes on the sideline. I think it's Muller has been suspended from the match for 2 minutes and she's not impressed.
Green card. Suspension. Germany's number 28,
so Germany down one player now for the next 2 minutes. And that will not help them. What can New Zealand make of it? Good stop there. Almost, that was almost made it through. Lisa Hahn, that was courageous play from her, from Germany. Sharland in the midfield for New Zealand. New Zealand will be desperate to take advantage of the fact that Germany are down a player. Plus for Germany. Here goes Mavis. It's a good ball. Keller. Corner given. Players open, can Finlayson get it to Punt with all the pace? Forgeson. Ruling goes against her. Renner takes the Parson into the circle. It comes. Germany press. Chance for a reverse stick shot. Saved again by Russell. And the ball will be New Zealand's. What a hero she's been for her country today. Bianca Russell, solid as a rock in New Zealand's goal. Ten minutes to play now. New Zealand nil, Germany nil. That's excellent stick work. Oh, just losing control, Gemma Flynn. Hillman gives it to Mavis. Still in possession. Cooper playing her 46th match for New Zealand today, and there is Bianca Russell. So Germany, 9 minutes remaining, and they need to score 3 goals in the last 9 minutes. And frustration starting to get the better of them. New Zealand, a draw will enhance their chances of making the semi-finals. Not guarantee it, though. Oh, that's well stopped. Punts. She's quick. Trying to get the penalty corner for New Zealand. Player off a leg of Mula Veland, but just couldn't quite get the break she was looking for. Well trapped. Sharland. It's issues. Back to Sharland. That's good for New Zealand. This is Harrison. Now away come Germany. Three players forward. Plass holds it up for a second, waits for more support, but punt. New Zealand called on to defend once again here. Rinner. Stöckel. Keller. Plass off the leg of her, so New Zealand's ball. Ooh, deflection. Now Glynn has it. She's on her own, though. Can she get the ball to Finlayson further up? And we've got another green card here. Another. Oh, it's a yellow card this time. Lisa Roach, the Australian official's had enough. So yellow card is a minimum of 5 minutes. So, and it's the same player who received the green card too, Julia Müller. So Germany are going to have to play 5 of these last 6 minutes with 10 players. And here's a chance for New Zealand, perhaps. Glynn. Can she find her teammates? Penalty corner. Forgeson taken out there by Schürzer. Good shove in the back. So huge pressure on Germany now. Player with a yellow card. Penalty corner against them. New Zealand's only third penalty corner of the game. Up to this point, they've been averaging 5 or 6 a game. Saved by Frank. Finlayson still has it. Just wide. So time running out for Germany now, inside the last 5 minutes. New Zealand would dearly love to pinch a goal here and secure their place in the semi-finals. Germany, remember, down to 10 players for another 3 minutes. Flynn losing control of that one. Germany, real urgency about their play now, but Finlayson has it. Sharland gives the ball. New Zealand 3-on-2. Forgeson. This is punt. Forgeson tries to get it in. Oh, it's still there. Keller comes away for Germany. Naylor, New Zealand's most experienced player. And now, and Flynn sees on the ball again. Finlayson tries to find Flynn again. It's good defence from Germany. No need to panic. Panicking's the last thing you want to do at this moment. Game starting to open up in these last few minutes as both teams press for a goal. Here come Germany this time. Mula Wieland. Pretty effective cross, but defended by New Zealand. Issues. Germany have got to press forward now. They've got no other option. Mark Hager, the New Zealand coach, won't be overly impressed with his team's performance. Will it be good enough to get them into the semi-final as Sharland cuts it out again. Here's Flynn with some wheels. Flynn, oh, excellent defending. You've got to take your hat off there to Haas. Sharland in there trying to win it for New Zealand. 2 minutes to play. Germany still down a player for another 30 or so seconds. Glynn. And which way's that gone? Very strong player, Katie Glynn. I think that's off the New Zealander. Yes, it was. Sharland, solid as a rock in midfield. Just couldn't get a good pass to Finlayson, but New Zealand still have it. Catherine Finlayson. A minute and 16 to play. Inside the last minute, New Zealand 0, Germany 0. Been a very entertaining match though, despite no goals being scored. And if no goal comes in these next 2 seconds, Germany will be out of the Olympic Games, the third seeds. New Zealand will be having to wait to see if they make the semi-finals for other matches. And that will be New Zealand's ball. Punt racing to get it. I think time is going to count against them. Punt, can they get a goal right on the last 2 seconds? And that is it. It's been an entertaining match. Bianca Russell, the New Zealand goalkeeper, arguably the player of her side, several tremendous stops. Yvonne Frank also had a very good match for Germany. Final score in this Pool B women's hockey match, New Zealand 0, Germany 0. So the result of this match will mean that Germany will not make the semi-finals. And New Zealand's chances of making the semi-finals are looking pretty good at this stage, but they're going to have to wait for the results of one other match to see whether they can confirm their place in the semi-finals. So in fact, New Zealand may have in fact secured a place in the semi-finals for the first time in their history, the Olympic Games. So big achievement for them. Really big achievement for them. Nil all though is the final score. Entertaining match. Germany probably a little unlucky not to win it, but hand it to that New Zealand team. They defended well and they had an excellent goalkeeping performance today from their goalkeeper Bianca Russell. So the final score at the Riverbank Arena in this women's pool B match is nil all. So an entertaining match between New Zealand and Germany. It's ended nil all. New Zealand, though, into the semi-finals for the first time in their history at the Olympic Games.